Hi, my friend, and how are you doing? And then I am planning to tell you that how this timing chain, here is this engine, that how this timing chain stretches and worn out, and how it is possible. Because if we have engine, and when we can know that this my timing chain is bad or then okay and good, what is this time? There is now thing that like these Toyota cars timing chains, they are really durable and they can last in USA and in Europe huge amount of mileage and kilometers. And like in this my Toyota Corollas, this dual VVT-i engines, this timing chain is now, there is mileage 150,000 miles. And this timing chain is still okay, no any issues. And I believe that this timing chain, it lasts about 250,000 miles or even 300,000 miles. And it is huge amount of mileage and kilometers. And then, of course, we have some cars, like in this BMW cars, where we have these small engines, like this 2-liter engine, and even those little bit smaller engines, that there has been situation that these timing chains, like in here, they have been stretched too long, even in very small mileage and kilometers, like something like 70,000 kilometers, even 50,000 kilometers, and this timing chain is too long. And how it is possible? There is one thing that when BMW, they have made those very high engineering engines, and they have tried to do those engines so lean and so weak that all parts are so small, and even this timing chain is same size like bicycle's chain, that every part is so small than possible, and the target is that then this car consumes really low amount of gasoline. But then there is this issue that this timing chain, it can be stretched. And how this stretch happens? Here is this my example. This green part is like timing chain, and it is in here that kind of part, like in here. And then when we have big forces, look that part in here, and then big forces and big horsepowers in that way, this chain became bigger, look, in here. Now this is starting point, and then it little bit wider and wider, and it is then too long. And now I saw also that there is this black mark, that this is starting point, and then when we drive like 50,000 miles and we have too lean and small at this timing chain, like in this BMW case, if you are owner of those cars, and then this became, look, it became longer. This is starting point, and then when we drive big amount, it is then longer. And then we have these issues, that what happens when this timing chain becomes too long. First issue is that when this crankshaft and this camshafts, they must be in same, just this chain balance in that way. They move. This is starting point in here when we have new engine, and then when engine runs, they are always in that kind of like direct line. But then when this chain becomes too long, like this, it stretches in that way, in this way, then this starting point balance changes so that then these parts are in this kind of situation. and then they are not yet anymore in line, they are a little bit in wrong all time. And then when they are in wrong line, then this our engine, it don't work anymore like a new one. We have bad idle speed, and then we can hear some extra sound, because this timing chain, when it becomes too hot, it keeps that kind of sound. Listen. And there is all kind of rattling sound. But the biggest issues are that when this timing chain is too long, then this camshafts and then this crankshaft timing is wrong. And crankshaft moves all times pistons. And then the camshafts in here, they open those valves. And then if there is wrong mixture, piston is like going in wrong direction, and then spark plug gives spark in wrong time, and then our engine is running poorly and badly. And even later it stops. Okay, and then of course you like to know that how we can see that is this my car, like if this is BMW's engine, that is this my timing in wrongly. And next I will show to you that how it happens, that how I can check my cars, even that it is BMW or then this Toyota Corolla's dual VVT engine, that is this my car's timing okay or wrong. And let's look that how you can do it, and I will show that to you. Okay, and let's continue. Timing marks positions Toyota Corolla dual VVT engine. First mark 0, 0, and that dot, they are in same line. This is first mark in here, and then second line is that. When we look in this up area, there is this piston one is in up position. When we insert measurement tool, this is in up position. And then this is second thing. Third thing is that exhaust VVTi systems line is in just in that central line in here. It is just in this central direction through that line in here. And then this is third thing, and fourth thing is then that this intake VVTi system line is in that hole in here. That one. I take this hole in here. Directly same line. And there is some dot in there inner area. And that means that intake is in here, not in here. And then there are those yellow labels when we install this back. And this is fourth, third, second, and one in first in here.